Hello everybody, hope all of you are well and please maintain the distance in public place and always use mask in public place. And today I will discuss the marking scheme of your Happy Ali exam. So your full marks was 40 marks in Happy Ali. And now your first question was question 1. Choose the correct answer from the options given below. In a sodium chloride crystals, each chloride ion is surrounded by 6 sodium ions, 6 chloride ions, 8 sodium ions and 4 sodium ions. In your sodium chloride crystals, okay, 1 sodium is surrounded by 6 chlorine atoms and 1 chlorine is surrounded by or coordinated by 6 sodium atoms, okay. So each chloride ion is surrounded by 6 sodium ions. So your answer will be option A, 6 sodium ions. An aqueous solution of urea freezes at minus 0.186 degree centigrade. K for water is given 1.86 Kelvin kg per mole. The boiling point of urea will be what? Options are given A, 373.065 K. Option B is given 373.186 K. Option C is given 373.512 K. And option D is given 373.0512 Kelvin. Okay. So here we have to use this formula that we know that delta TV is equal to KV into M. And delta TF is equal to KF into M. So if we write delta TD divided by delta TF, then it will be KV by KF. Now we know that delta TV value, we have to calculate the delta TV value. And KV is given 0.512. Okay. If it is not given, you have to remember that delta T is equal to KB is equal to 0.512 Kelvin per mole. And KF value is given, is supplied, it is 1.86. And delta TF is 0.186. So if you calculate, you will get the delta T value will be 0.0512 degree centigrade. So the boiling point of urea solution will be urea solution will be 100 plus 0.0512 degree centigrade. So it will be 100.0512 degree centigrade. So if you convert in Kelvin, it will be 377.0512 Kelvin. So your option D is correct, that is 373.0512 Kelvin. Next question is given, when tetraamine chlorido nitrito cobalt 3 nitrate is dissolved in water, how many ions will be formed from one molecule? 4, 3, 2, 0. First, you have to write the or draw the complex molecule, that is CO, NH3 whole 4, Cl, NO2, NO3. So when you will dissociate, that coordination here will not dissociate, remain intact. This one minus, this one plus and this one minus. So only two ions will be generated, the two ions. So your answer will be option C, 2. Next, the structure of IF7 is trigonal bipyramidal, octahedral, pentagonal bipyramidal, square pyramidal. You know that it is SP3DG. Okay, definitely it will be pentagonal bipyramidal. So, option C is the correct answer. Next question, when acetaldehyde is treated with Grignard reagent followed by hydrolysis, the product is formed. Definitely in case of formaldehyde, you will get primary alcohol. Acetaldehyde, you will get the secondary alcohol. And if you take acetone, then you will get tertiary alcohol. Okay. So your answer will be, in this case, question number 5 will be option B. That is the secondary alcohol. Next is fill in the blanks. Okay, with appropriate words from those given in the brackets. So number of unpaired electron in the tetrachloridonickelate 2 ion is. So tetrachloridonickelate 2 ion NiCl 4 2 minus. So nickel here DH system. DH system means 2 unpaired electron. So your answer will be 2. The number of unpaired electron in tetrachloridonickelate 2 ion is 2. Pure chloroform is formed by heating chloral hydrate, or you can write chloral, with aqueous solution of sodium hydroxide. So formula is CCl3CHO dot H2. Next option, methyl alcohol. Methyl alcohol, you have to write this unfit for drinking purpose. So unfit is the answer. The order of reaction rarely exceeds 3. In a Daniell cell, the copper vessel serves as cathode. Cathode will be the answer. Answer the following questions in brief. Name the aldehyde which does not give failing solution test. Your answer will be benzaldehyde. Okay. Aromatic aldehyde do not respond to this failing test. Or does not respond to this failing test. So benzaldehyde will be your answer. Which reagent directly converts carboxylic acid to alcohol? You can write lithium aluminum hydride, diborate, B2H6 water. You can write CH2CuCr2O4. This type of reagents you can write. Write the name of the major product when phenol undergoes Riemann-Tiemann reaction. Your product will be this one. This is called salicylaldehyde. Orthohydroxybenzaldehyde. So this is your major product. In case of para will be also formed. Okay, that is the parahydroxybenzaldehyde. The minor or major ortho will be the major product. Next, name the process where on a large scale chlorobenzene can be obtained by passing a mixture of benzene vapors, air and HCl over heated cupric chloride. Answer will be the Rassig process. Okay, when you are giving that benzene, HCl and O2 in presence of CuCl to apply heat, then there will be formation of chlorobenzene. And we can prepare in large scale in industry. This process is known as Rassig process. Your answer will be Rassig process. Next question, a first order reaction 50% completed in 20 minutes. What is the rate constant? So we know that K is equal to 0.693 divided T half. So 0.693 here, T half is mentioned, that is 20. So from here you will get the value 0.0346 millid inverse. So this one will be your answer, that is 0.0346 millid inverse. State Faraday's second law of electrolysis. It states that when the same quantity of electricity is passed through different electrolytic solutions, the weights different substances produced at the electrodes are proportional to their equivalent weights. Next question, what are maximum boiling azeotropes? These are formed by liquid pairs which show negative deviations from ideal behavior. Such an azeotrope corresponds to an intermediate composition for which the total vapor pressure is lowest and the boiling point is the highest. Such azeotropes having boiling point higher than the either of the pure components. Some important example we can tell, HCl water or HCl nitric acid. If we consider water and HCl, water boiling point 373 Kelvin and HCl is 188 Kelvin. So azeotrope boiling will be higher compared to this boiling point, that will be 381.6 Kelvin. Okay. Next question is given, what is nitrolim? Nitrolim is nothing but calcium cyanamide. CaNCl. CaNCl. This is the nitrolim. This is generally used as a fertilizer. Okay. Next question, among all the noble gases, which one can be liquefied easily? So your answer will be radon, because its size is the highest of noble gases, as well as so van der Waal attractive force will be high, okay, highest, okay, and it will be very easier to liquefy. Next question is given, what is the strongest oxoacid of chlorine? Definitely it will be the parchloric acid HClO4. Okay. You can think about HClO, HClO2, HClO3, HClO4. HClO4 when it will release one H plus, it will form ClO4 minus. It will be high stabilized by resonance. That is why parchloric acid is the strongest oxo acid of chlorine. Next, answer the following questions with proper reasons if required. 20 marks. Give IPC name of an outer orbital octahedral complex. You can write FeH2 whole 60 plus, FeH6 4 minus, COF6 3 minus. In case of FeH2 whole 60 plus, the IPC name will be hexairon thion. In case of FeH6 4 minus, the IPC name will be hexafluorido ferrate 2 ion. In case of COF6 3 minus, the IPC name will be hexafluorido cobaltate 3 ion. Name the gas used for the separation of nickel from impurities by Mohn process. The gas name will be the carbon monoxide. So carbon monoxide will react with nickel forming nickel tetracarbonine NiCO4, and if you apply it you will get the pure nickel. Next question is given in froth flotation process, how zinc sulfide can be separated from lead sulfide. Chemical equation not required given. Actually sodium cyanide is used as a depressant to separate the zinc sulfide from lead sulfide. Sodium cyanide will form zinc complex, okay, with ZnS forming Na2ZnCNO4. Na2ZnCNO4. This type of complex it will produce and that will deposit on the surface of the zinc sulfide and thereby prevent the formation of froth. Okay. But in case of lead sulfide, okay, it can easily form froth. So in this way we can easily separate, okay, can be separated from the froth flotation process from zinc sulfide to lead sulfide. Next question is given that what is copper metal? Actually cuprous sulfide containing some traces of ferrous sulfide is called copper metal, and in order to prevent oxidation of cuprous sulfide this is used. Your next question is why ketones do not easily undergo oxidation. Ketones requires the breaking of the strong carbon-carbon bond for oxidation. Therefore, the mild oxidizing agents like phthalates, benedicts, tolins will not work here. You have to use strong oxidizing agent like KNO4 sulfuric acid, concentrated nitric acid or potassium dichromate sulfuric acid. But these will break the carbon-carbon bond, but you will get the carboxylic acid lower than the parent chain. Next question is how will you distinguish between the acetone and ethyl alcohol? You know that 2,4-DNP, 2,4-dinitrophenyl hydrogen, that is called Brady's reagent. If you add Brady's reagent with acetone, because of presence of carbonyl group, it will give that 2,4-dinitrophenyl hydrogen. Okay, that means you will get a orange PPT of hydrogen in case of acetone, but no such precipitation in case of ethanol. So in this way, you can easily distinguish between acetone and ethanol. Write the decreasing order of the acidity of the following ROH, AROH, RCOOH, water. So decreasing order, the acid will be the highest, then phenol will come, the highest acidity order. Then there will come phenol, AROH, then water will come, then alcohol will come. Now in this case, why water is more acidic compared to the alcohol? Because if we think about the conjugate base, when it will form OH minus here, RO minus is destabilized by the inductive effect of R group. That is why water is better acid or higher acid strength is higher compared to the alcohol. Next question is given, what is the basic difference of the reactant molecule in case of Cannizzaro reaction and aldol condenser? Generally, aldehydes having the alpha hydrogen will give the Cannizzaro reaction. So, this is the alpha position and this compound have alpha hydrogens. So, in case of reactant molecule, in case of aldol condensation, okay, aldol condensation, the molecule should contain alpha hydrogen. So molecules having alpha hydrogen will give the aldol condensation, but molecules having the no alpha hydrogen, they will give the Cannizzaro reaction. So this will give aldol condensation, aldol condensation and this formaldehyde will give the Kenny-Jarrow reaction because it has no alpha hydrogen. And it has alpha hydrogen. So reactant molecules having alpha hydrogen will give the aldol condensation, and reactant molecules having no alpha hydrogen will take part in the Kenny-Jarrow reaction. Next is given, arrange the following compounds in the increasing order of their acidic strength: 4-nitrophenol, phenol, and 2,4,6-dinitrophenol. So if you introduce nitro group in the phenol compound, definitely because of minus R effect and minus I effect, it will increase the acidity order. So the order of acidity will be, so phenol is the least acidic, then four nitrophenol and 2,4,6-dinitrophenol is the highest acidic. And this compound is known as picric acid. This compound is even higher acid compared to the benzic acid also. Okay, so this 3 nitro group, electron withdrawing of nitro group increases the acidity. Okay, so this will be the increasing order of the acidity. Next question is given, why during distillation of old ether it should be never be evaporated to diene? Because ether will react with the oxygen, okay, then it will form peroxides. If you keep ether for a long time, it, inside there is air, so it will form peroxides. So when you are even distilling, so if you go to the last drop, okay, then what will happen? You have to eat the peroxide, then there will be explosion. So to avoid explosion, okay, ether should not be, especially for old ether, should not be distilled to dryness. Next question is given, why phenol does not react with carbonates and bicarbonates, although it is acidic in nature? Phenols are considerably weaker acids than the carbonic acid, okay, or weaker acid compared to the carbonic acid, okay, and hence do not decompose the carbonates and bicarbonates. Phenols are stronger acid compared to the alcohol, because if we draw the structure of phenoxide, then it will be easily stabilized by resonance structure. Okay, so that is why phenols are stronger acid than alcohol, but as it is a weaker acid than carboxylic acid, so these phenols, okay, do not decompose the carbonates and bicarbonates. Next question is given, how will you distinguish chemically between chlorobenzene and chlorohexane? So chlorohexane is easily hydrolyzed by mild alkali, okay, and chlorobenzene will not hydrolyzed, okay. So chlorohexane, if we draw the structure, you can understand chlorohexane, this is chlorobenzene, this is chlorohexane, and this is chlorobenzene. So in case of chlorohexane, it will be easily hydrolyzed by mild NaOH, okay, and there will be formation of, if you give NaOH, there will be formation of NaCl. That NaCl will react with silver nitrate to form heavy white cavity of silver chloride, that will be soluble in ammonium hydroxide, okay. But in case of chlorobenzene, as the CCl bond gains the double bond character, so it is not easy, okay, to hydrolyze by sodium hydroxide, okay, mild condition. Okay, so it will not form any precipitate with silver nitrate. Okay, so you can understand in this case that chlorocyclohexane will be hydrolyzed by NaOH and will form sodium chloride. If you add silver nitrate solution, then there will be heavy white cavity of silver chloride. Next question is given, that a BCC element has a cell edge of 420 picometer. Calculate its density in gram per centimeter cube, given the atomic mass of the element is 65. So all of you know the formula of density. If we start, D is equal to what? Z into M divided by A cube into N0. So if you put the value 2 into 65 divided by 420 picometer into 10 to the power minus 10 whole cube, into 6.023, that is the Avogadro number, into 10 to the power 23. If you calculate, you will get 2.913 gram per centimeter cube. This will be your answer. Next question is given in a cubic type of unit cell. A atoms are one half faces and B atoms are at the corners of the cube. Calculate the formula of the compound. So number of A atoms that will be equal to 3 into half 3 by 2, and number of B atoms they are at the corner 8 into 1 by 8 1. Therefore ratio of A is to B will be 3 by 2 is to 1, so that will be 3 is to 2. Therefore the formula of the compound will be H3B2. Okay, this will be your answer, H3B2. Next question, 46 gram of ethyl alcohol is dissolved in 18 gram of water. Calculate the mole fraction of ethyl alcohol. So number of moles of ethyl alcohol you have to calculate. So molecular of ethyl alcohol is also 46. So ethyl alcohol mole will be 1 in case of 46 gram ethyl alcohol. And 18 gram of water is also, molecular of water is 18, so this is also 1 mole. So total number of mole will be 2. Total number of mole will be 1 plus 1, 2. And so mole fraction of ethanol will be 1 by 2, that will be 0.5. This will be your answer. Next question is given, the boiling point of pure water is 373 Kelvin. Calculate the boiling point of an aqueous solution containing 18 gram glucose in 100 gram of water. Given that Kb of water 0.52 and carbon, oxygen, hydrogen atomic numbers are given. Atomic masses are given. So here you have to calculate the delta TV. Delta TV is equal to Kb into W into 1000 divided by molecular weight of glucose solute into W solvent. So if you put the value, this is 0.52 and this is 18 and this one is 1000 divided by 180 into 100. If you calculate, you will get 0.52. So the boiling point of the solution that will be 100 plus 0.52 degree centigrade, that is 100.52 degree centigrade. That will be your answer. Next question is given that the conductivity of 0.2 molar, okay, 0.2 molar KCl solution is 3 into 10 to the power minus 2 ohm inverse centimeter inverse. Calculates its molar conductance. So here we have to put the formula, that is lambda m is equal to kappa into 1000 divided by m or c. So 3 into 10 to the power minus 2 into 1000 divided by 0.2. That will be 150 ohm inverse centimeter square mole inverse. That will be your answer. Next question is given, calculate the potential of hydrogen electrode in contact with a solution whose pH is 10. So here we know that pH is equal to E cell divided by 0.0591. So if you calculate E cell, that will be 0.0591 into 10, 0.591 volt. Now E cell is equal to E cathode minus E anode. So that will be E cell is 0.591, 0.00 minus e electrode. So from here you will get the value of electrode, that will be minus 0.591 volt. So this will be your answer. Okay. Next question is given, a first order reaction is 20% complete in 5 minutes. Calculate the time taken to complete 60% of the reaction. So first you have to calculate the K. So we know that K is equal to 2.303 divided by T log A by A minus X. So here 2.303 by 5 log 100 divided by 80. So if you calculate, you will get the value of K is equal to 0.045 minute inverse. So here T is equal to, in another case, 2.303 divided by K log A by A minus X. Now if we put the value, that is 2.303 divided by 0.045 log 100 divided by 40, because 60% complete. Okay. So if you calculate, you will get the value 20.36 minutes. Okay, this is the your answer. Last question, the right one difference between molecularity and order of a reaction. All of you know that molecularity is always a whole number and order may be zero, order may be fraction. Okay. Now, order of a reaction is an experimental determined quantity. Okay. And molecularity also depend upon the reaction mechanism. Okay. A theoretical concept. So, in this way, I have completed Happy Ali exam, chemistry exam answer scheme. Hope all of you can understand. If you have any doubt, you can send me questions, okay, or your query through your school body. So today after this, please stay safe and maintain the distance in public space, as well as must use face mask, okay, in public space. Thank you.